Welcome, welcome, welcome to The Tonight Show. You're here. You made it. Thank you for watching. Well, it was a crazy windy day here in New York City, wasn't it? Gusts were reaching 60 miles an hour. 60 miles an hour. Yeah, it was great. Coming into work, I felt like Beyonce. That's how I was waving to people. Hi. The wind was so strong today, a Boeing put extra scotch tape on their wings. Oh. I thought that was nice. Meanwhile, daylight savings was over the weekend, and today is considered the groggiest day of the year. This morning, everyone in the office had the vibe of Al Pacino at the Oscars. You know what I'm saying? That's right, last night was the 96th Oscars. Congratulations to Jimmy Kimmel, who did a great job hosting, by the way. Good. Great job. Oppenheimer was the big winner, taking home 7 awards, including Best Picture, while the award for Most Paused Picture went to John Cena. And... I mean, God bless John. I could never do something like that. If I did, I'd win the Oscar for Best Short. Do you know what I'm saying? Hey, as I mentioned, people are talking about this. Al Pacino presented the award for Best Picture, and he sparked some confusion with the way he announced the winner. Take a look at this.
10 wonderful films were nominated, but only one will take the award for Best Picture. And I have to go to the envelope for that. Here it comes. And my eyes see Oppenheimer. Yes. Yes.
It's okay, that wasn't the whole point of the night or anything. I mean, wow. Well, switching gears, some political news. When asked whether he would debate former President Trump, President Biden said, it depends on his behavior. Ooh. It's odd, because usually when you hear the words Trump, Biden, and depends in the same sentence, it's about something else. Yeah, it depends on Trump's behavior. Good luck with that. Trump's been in his terrible twos for the last 75 years. Well, this is big. Congress is thinking about banning TikTok. Yeah. They're saying it's a national security threat because of its ties to China. And now a bill to ban the app is headed to the House. And it really caught people off guard, kind of like...
Oh, my gosh. What do I do?
Because people really love TikTok. They're not going to go down easy, kind of like...
Poke a hole in it.
They just want to have fun at the app, but it could all come crashing down, kind of like...
Hey, Ron.
Hey, Billy.
How often does that happen?
Hey, Ron. Hey, Billy. Hey, man. You didn't take the front door. You came through the ceiling that time, yeah. The company could reach a deal with lawmakers, but we need a breakthrough, kind of like... Anyways, here's hoping they can work it out or else they're going to fall on their face, kind of like...
We never ask you students to do anything we wouldn't do ourselves.
Well, we'll see what we'll see what happens. Some more business news. I saw that Airbnb has banned indoor security cameras. Yeah, I'll give you a minute to remember every Airbnb you ever stayed in and what you did there. So now if you want to be creepily spied on, you'll have to stay at Motel 6. I'm sorry. Well, listen to this. I read that a vegan bakery in New York is under investigation for allegedly trying to pass off Dunkin' Donuts as their own. Oh. People got suspicious when the vegan donuts tasted good. The owner of the vegan bakery is like, in our defense, the whole is gluten-free. Well, this is wild. According to a new report, an Indonesian flight veered off course after both pilots fell asleep for nearly half an hour. The last thing you want to hear is over the pilot's intercom is... Even worse, the pilots woke up and go, sorry, red wine makes us sleepy. That's the problem. We won't do that again. And finally, before we move on, I'd like to take a moment to thank some of our sponsors for tonight's show. They don't always fit in the commercial breaks, and we want to make sure we mention all of them. It's time for tonight's show sponsors. Tonight's show sponsors. Tonight's show sponsors. Hummus. Spackle you can eat. Zillow. Quick, minimize the window. Your boss is coming. Preparation H. You don't even want to know what preparations A through G were. Hermes. If you pronounce it Hermes, you probably can't afford our staff. Outback Steakhouse. Basically an Applebee's that won't stop talking about that one trip to Australia. Victoria's Secret. We know you stare at our mannequins. 7-Eleven, two bites of one of our hot dogs can get you out of work tomorrow. Barnes & Noble, a giant maze where you're a mouse and the bathroom is the cheese. Hunt's Ketchup, haha, you meant to get Heinz and grab dust by mistake, sucker. And finally, Capital One, if you're not interested in this credit card we just mailed you, no worries. We'll send you another one tomorrow. That's all for tonight's show sponsors. We have a great show. Give it up for the Roots, everybody. Wow, down. Keep a stance on or sit yourself down. All the way from 215 to Bucktown. Brace yourself, y'all. It's going down. Welcome to the show, everybody. Dude, I had a really fun weekend. I did a surprise stand-up. I did 10 minutes of stand-up. I surprised people in Syracuse, New York, and Albany, New York. I opened for Nate Bargatze, who's amazing. But Julian McCullough was there. Julian McCullough, super funny. Mike James, Joe Zimmerman, Stephen Rogers. Nate asked me to do this like 3 months ago, and I just said, all right, I'll just go. And so I flew to Syracuse and surprised the audience. It was like 12,000 people or something. And when that's where you go to try material.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, stuff like that. But it was super fun. These guys are the best. And then Nate had these tour buses, and we all got on the tour bus overnight, like in these little bunks, and just talking about comedy and stuff like that. And then I woke up. I was in Albany, and that's where I went to college. So I went to visit the College of St. Rose. I went to my old college. I went to my old apartment.
Ooh.
And rang the doorbell. Two kids came down and go, hey, what's up, man? And they're like, can we help you? And I'm like, no, I used to live here. And they're like, are you Jimmy? And I go, yeah. They go, what's going on, dude? They thought they were getting punked or something. I don't know. Took a picture with those guys. Then I crashed a frat party.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. I went in. I just saw on Hudson there was all kids standing outside. It was eggs and kegs. Oh. Is that a thing? I don't know what that is. But I went in there. I walked in. I was like, hey, guys, what's up? And they're like, Are you gonna come to our party? I go, yeah, I'll come in or whatever. Just check in, check it out. They were so nice, very polite. Thank you, whatever frat that was. They're just fun, having a good time. Then I went to this hotel for the second night before I went and did the gig, and it was raining, and I forgot to eat lunch, and I had like a bag of potato chips from something, and I was just eating chips by myself alone. Just kind of sad. It was just kind of sad. Going over my 10 minutes over and over for hours. You don't understand how psycho that is, right? It's like, but I used to do it. Do you remember? You did stand up?
That's how it goes, yeah. That's what you do.
It felt like I was back
in
the day.
Back in time. You took a trip back
in
time.
It was really awesome. Then I went. I did stand up for everyone at the MVP Arena, and it was so fun. And I'm going to do it again. I want to go back. So I want to thank everyone. Thank you, Nate. Thanks, everyone, so much. Guys, I also want to mention tomorrow night at 10 p.m. on NBC is the season 2 premiere of Password. Oh. Come on. It's a fun show. Joe Manganiello is on. Emmy Award winner Kiki Palmer's hosting. It's going to be good. Fun for the whole family. Tomorrow night, 10 p.m. on NBC, and then the next day on Peacock. But first, what a show we have for you tonight. They star in the new limited series, A Gentleman in Moscow, which premieres March 29th on Paramount Plus. Ewan McGregor and Mary Elizabeth Winstead are here tonight. Plus, she is a talented actress who's making her New York stage debut in Little Shop of Horrors, which is playing now at the West Side Theater. Evan Rachel Wood is here tonight. Evan Rachel Wood in Little Shop. And we got great music from one of my favorites. God, this guy can do no wrong. He is unbelievable. If you don't know him, get to know him. Today is his birthday.
Oh.
The very talented Marcus King is here tonight. Mood Swings is the album. Marcus King. Stick around when we come back. We're playing Password with some very special guests. Hey, hey.